Dr. Robert Kadlec, HHS's Assistant Secretary for Preparedness and Response, and Dr. Stephen Hahn, the Commissioner of Food and Drugs. As of this morning, we still have only 14 cases of the China coronavirus detected here in the United States, involving travel to China or close contacts with those travelers. We have 3 cases among Americans repatriated from Wuhan, and we have 40 cases among American passengers repatriated from the Diamond Princess in Japan. I want to thank the responders and communities that have worked with HHS and the administration to provide these Americans with the treatment they need. I'm also grateful to the governors and other state and local leaders who have worked with us in close partnership so far. The immediate risk to the general American public remains low. But as we have warned, that has the potential to change quickly. There is now community transmission in a number of countries, including outside of Asia. That's deeply concerning, and community spread in other countries will make successful containment at our borders harder and harder. That's why we've already been working closely with state, local, and private sector partners to prepare for mitigating the virus's potential spread in the United States, because we will likely see more cases here, as we have said throughout this episode. Dr. Shuket will provide some more details on what that will look like, including how we would treat potential cases that arise from community transmission here in the United States. This preparation has been possible in part because of how aggressively President Trump has responded to this outbreak. As soon as we knew of the threat presented by this novel virus, public health leaders were monitoring it and beginning to prepare. The travel restrictions that the president put in place at the beginning of this month have given our country valuable time to continue to prepare, and that is precisely what those measures were designed to do. That includes working with Congress. Yesterday, the White House sent a request to Congress to make at least $2.5 billion in funding available for preparedness and response. There are 5 major priorities within the supplemental request, which I underscored this morning before the Senate Appropriations Committee. First, we need to expand our surveillance work, building on an existing system we have within CDC's influenza surveillance network. Second, we will need funds to support public health preparedness and response for state and local governments for what could be a very large-scale response. We don't know, but we must prepare for that just in case. This support complements the significant funds that these partners have received from CDC for preparedness, about 2/3 of $1 billion a year in recent years. Third and fourth, we need to support the development of therapeutics and the development of vaccines. Given the scale of this outbreak, the private sector sees a real market for both kinds of countermeasures, as well as for diagnostics, but federal funding and guidance can accelerate this work. Dr. Fauci will address the current status of that work in more depth. Fifth and finally, we need funds for the purchase of personal protective equipment for the Strategic National Stockpile, a topic that Dr. Kadlec can address. I'll conclude by noting that though scheduling conflicts prevented this briefing from including other members of the President's Coronavirus Task Force, we'll be providing a new update from interagency leaders soon, and we expect to continue doing so regularly. Earlier this afternoon on CNBC, the National Economic Council Director Larry Kudlow offered an update on how we see this outbreak affecting the economy. This morning, Dr. Messonnier from CDC provided the usual telebriefing. As Dr. Shuket will emphasize in just a moment, the Trump administration will continue to be aggressively transparent as the outbreak and our response evolve. We'll continue keeping the American people and the media apprised of the situation, as well as what everyone can do to prepare. In the meantime, I'll continue to work closely with President Trump and the President's task force on our preparations to keep Americans safe.